when I was growing up, I'd always loved watching cartoons. As a kid, I didn't have summer camp, and instead I did soccer camps. But that was far less time-consuming, so I had a lot of time to watch TV. I remember I was always excited to watch cartoons every morning, but I was especially excited when it would be animated with stop motion. Stop motion is the earliest form of animation, a filming technique in which successive positions of objects are photographed to produce the appearance of movement. A show or movie series I always enjoyed watching was Wallace and Gromit by Aardman Animations. Then there's also movies like Coraline, The Nightmare Before Christmas, Fantastic Mr. Fox, Kubo, The Lego Movie, Paranorman, and even Beetlejuice, which combined both video and stop motion. And there are plenty more where that came from. As you can clearly see, the medium of stop motion is still very much thriving. But the question is, what makes it thrive? Why is it still a popular medium despite being the oldest form of animation? But before we do that, let's go into some history of the form. Stop motion should be dead when you think about it. It is the first way animation was ever made. It's time consuming, laboring, and technology has moved faster with CGI. From what we've seen of these new digital movies, they've made tons of progress in terms of quality over the past 20 years. With movies like Toy Story, Avatar, Star Wars, Jurassic Park, The Matrix, and many more. The first known stop-motion feature was The Lost World by Harry O. Hoyt in 1925. It was about these people dropped into the world of dinosaurs where they had to survive. The special effects of the dinosaurs were animated with stop-motion, while the actors were filmed normally. The use of stop-motion in this movie showed something never seen in cinema before, and it blew the minds of many at the time. However, as we know, CGI took over, and stop-motion was used less and less for special effects. Naturally, you see this as a dying medium, but despite that, many movies including the original Star Wars trilogy, Jaws 3, Ghostbusters, The Terminator, Aliens, and even in The Force Awakens in 2019, and many more where that came from. And it makes sense, with fully-fledged popular stop-motion films coming out, everyone loved them. But why? Why did they love them? Sure, the great stories, imaginative worlds, and unique art style, but there's something else to it. Stop-motion is something I believe that got me into film today, as I have made several animations before. After every time I'd finally put something together after a long while of taking photos, I'd think, hey, I made that happen, even after the hours I took making it. The amount of effort and time that goes into these projects are unmeasurable. There's that sense of craftsmanship and pure physical effort that goes into these films. I remember watching these stop motion films growing up and seeing all the handmade props and worlds and just admiring them. Professor Christopher Walsh, an instructor for the prestigious animation program at Sheridan College in Canada, said, "That human connection in an increasingly digital polished age is reassuring to an audience. An age where these corporations like Disney dominate the field of film, stop motion is like a time when films were made by independent businesses that had that direct customer to owner connection. It's the unknown connection you have with the people behind the movie that makes the medium so special." That's what I believe keeps stop motion thriving and me coming back to watch more. I mean, who knows? It's very hard to describe the feeling stop motion gives me.